Happy. be here today. I tell you, first of all, I lost a girlfriend Sunday night. Michael, she told Pam when we got married about 37 years ago, she was mad at her. Because she stole her boyfriend, you know. But then when my son come along, he beat me out. And then she took up with Jacob then, so I fell out then again. So, but you know, I just thank God for his hand and how she can make you feel. And she always encouragement. Every time I seen her, she said, "That's Tiffany Griffin." Yes. And she is always a good-hearted person. She loved her family. And every time I seen her, she said, "Please pray for my children and my family." And she loved every one of them. And, you know, I think today of the times that we had, well, we went to the beach first time we went with her and Hugh. And I was thinking, told Pam, I said, "I could just see Hugh getting mad at Ann because she's out fishing." And he just stomped the ground. He couldn't stand it. But she was a big fisherman. And back to the ocean, she'd catch shark. You could catch fish with that bait on the line. That's how good she was. She just that way, you know. And she's a wonderful person to be my wife. My wife, they talk on the phone a good bit. Couldn't get them off the phone. But they talk. They love one another. And, you know, we all want to miss her. But you know what? I want to tell you today, the Bible says this in Thessalonians. He says, "But I would not have you to be ignorant, brother, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not as others which have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him." So we see today this is not the end. This is just the beginning for Mama Ann, and you know, she went to a better place. The Bible said to be absent from the bodies and be present with the Lord. So Yes. She's around the throne of God today, and Yes. She's enjoying that time. I told Pam, I was talking to her, and I said, "I just wonder what kind of trouble that Ann and Francis and all them give to the Lord right now." They were trouble, okay? They always kept something going all the time. They were big shoppers. They liked to go shop together. And they'd come back and tell me and Pam the stories. Ann would tell on Francis most of the time. But Francis was a mess, my mother-in-law. But they were all big shoppers that like to shop. You know, today, I'd like to say, I feel more of a brother to y'all than I feel part of family from Pam, because I've known y'all a long time. Me and Clint used to run the road together. And old me and Pam got married, Clint was, he was always, most of the time, he was right there with me and Pam all the time back then. And me and Dennis, we've had a lot of good times. And Michael, I worked with Michael with my uncle. We've all been family for a long time. And we all going to miss her, but you know what? She's in a better place. Amen. It's a joy today to tell you that she's in a better place. She's not feeble anymore. We're going to have a new body.
Yes.
And all the pains and aches of this life, she don't have them anymore. Won't that be wonderful? I just thinking when I was coming over here, I'd like to see what Ann's seeing right now. I'd like to, Mike, I'd like to see what she's acknowledging right now before the Lord and the goodness and what heaven looks like. I would like to see that today. And, you know, we're gonna take part in this one day.
Yes.
I would tell every one of us today as a family, if Ann could tell us anything, I like to say this when I speak at a funeral, she would tell us to be ready.
Yes.
But the Word of God says, "Be you ready for the hour that you think not the Son of Man is going to appear in a great cloud of glory."
Yes.
And her heart today, I know, would be this, is her children to be ready to meet the Lord.
Amen.
Because she always tell me, "Please pray for my children."
Oh, yeah.
"Pray for my grandkids. Pray for my family." And she prayed for you. I know she did. She was a praying woman. She loved you. And, you know, I thank God for the time that we've had with her. Very encouraging woman. She loved me and Pam. She always is. I'll tell you a little story about my dad and mother-in-law. I was sitting there one night, and Julie said that Francis just all out of the blue. We hadn't been married a good while. Mom, she looked at him and said, "I hate Timmy Griffin." And Jerry said, "What are you talking about?" She said, "I took my baby." And I took her baby from her, her daughter, you know, she was her joy, you know. But Frances, later on in life, Miss Ann, her was out somewhere one day, and Ann asked her, said, "What?" She said, "What do you think about Tim now?" And she said, "I don't know what I would have done with that." So, you know, I thank God for the time that we had. And, you know, Ann, she told me that later on. She said, "Francis, I'm so glad to have you as a son-in-law. You know, I tried to show her love in my life." You know, that's what life's all about. Love will cover a multitude of sins. Love is what put Jesus on the cross for you today. But don't them Roman soldiers, I can tell you that today. If he wanted to, he'd call 12 legions of angels to get him down. But you know what? He loves us.
Yes.
That when we come to this time, that we can have a better life. The absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Miss Ann is with the Lord today.
Yes, she is.
She is ready to go.
Yes,
I hope and pray today that you get ready for this time. We don't know what our Lord is going to call. We don't know when he's going to call us. None of us do. You don't know today. You see me right now, you might not see me again on this side. But I'm sure today we'll see you one day after a while. And that's what Miss Ann, I just told my wife, I thought last night, Janice said, I could just see her just saying, "Now just come on over. Just come on over." You know, that's something to think about. We're just one breath away from eternity. We're one breath away from eternity. And we're going to face what Miss Ann faced Sunday night. But you know what? To know the Lord, what a joy. If you don't know the Lord today, my prayer is you find him.
Yes.
He'll knock. If you'll open, he'll come in. He is the door. He is the door today. I love you today. I appreciate all of you. Love every one of you. And I hope and pray that you know that your mother is in heaven today. Joy. What a joy to know that she's in heaven. She ain't suffering no more. I love you. Appreciate you.
Time in my childhood, we traveled so far.
be sure today that Miss Ann's at home. That song there that she loved to hear. I thought about Pam's dad loved that song too. It amazed me when I heard that she liked that song too, you know, and that's a good song. We are going to be going home one day. And I hope and pray today that I've said something to comfort your heart. Most of all, knowing that Jesus is there for you. He's a comforter today. You know, nothing we can say can help you. But you know, if you go to the Lord, Brother Michael, he can help you. He's always there. He's a very present help in a time of need.
Yes.
You know, at this time, we need to go to the Lord, and we need to lean on him. And he's the comforter. I'm glad today to know him. And you know, he said in the Word of God, when they come to the end of time, he said he's going to have to know you when you get into those gates. You know, and I want to know him. I want to have time with him and sup with him and pray. Prayer is to keep the kingdom. And he's just a prayer away. And he loves us today. I believe that. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you today for this family. We thank you for everyone that's here today. Lord, we look out through this crowd and we know today that Miss Ann has touched a lot of people's hearts today, a lot of people's lives. God, we just thank you for her today. We love you. We know she's in your hands today. We love this family, God. We just praise you, Lord. We thank you for them. Lord, we ask you to touch their lives today. Help those that's not ready to be ready, Lord, we pray. God, we give you praise today, glory and honor, Lord, for everything that you do for us. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.